Hello students, in the previous class we discussed some of the properties like atomic radii, ionic radii, molar volume, density, etc. Today we will discuss the most important property of a transition element, that is the magnetic property. Actually there are four important magnetic substances are there: the paramagnetic, diamagnetic, ferromagnetic and antiferromagnetic substances. If we consider any substances that contains some amount of magnetic field, if we subject that substance into an external field, that substance produces some amount of a magnetic field called as an induced magnetic field. If that induced magnetic field is in the direction of an applied field, then it is called as a paramagnetic. If the induced magnetic field is in the direction opposite to that of the external field, then it is called as a diamagnetic substances. This paramagnetism, that is due to the presence of unpaired electrons, and diamagnetism is due to the presence of paired electrons. Then the magnetic moment, that is partly due to the spin and orbital motion of the electrons. But in case of a transition elements, the unpaired electrons which are present in the outermost orbitals, so the orbital motion of these electrons are disturbed by the electrons of the ligands. So quenching takes place. In this case, only spin motion is considered. So here the magnetic moment that can be calculated by using the formula, spin only formula. Here the magnetic moment can be calculated by using a spin only formula, that is given by root of N into N plus 2 Bohr magneton. See here the electronic configuration of a second and third transitions elements are given here. See here the electronic configuration and oxidation states of second and third transition series are given. The yttrium to cadmium that constitute a second transition series, and hafnium to Hg that constitute a third transition series. Here lanthanum, that belongs to the F block elements because of their properties. The properties of the lanthanum, that is similar to that of a F block elements. These are the oxidation states of second and third transition series. Next one, the color formation in transition elements. If we compare S and P block elements, most of the D block elements are colored. The color of the transition elements, that is due to the wavelength of the light absorbed by the substance. Color of the substance is always complementary to the color of the light absorbed. Suppose for example, any substance like hydrated copper, if it absorbs a red light, then it appears blue because blue is a complementary color to red. Now we know that the d orbitals are split into two sets of energy levels, that is in case of a crystal field theory, and the two energy levels are lower energy level and higher energy level. The orbitals of a lower energy levels are dxy, dyz and dxz. There are two orbitals in the higher energy levels, they are dx square minus y square and dz square. In case of Ti3 plus, there are one electron, and that one electron can occupy the one of the orbital of the lower energy level, and here the lower energy level is represented as a T2g and higher energy level is represented as Eg. After the absorption of radiation, this one electron can excite it to the higher energy level, and here it absorbs yellow and green color of the white light, and again it comes to the original level with the emission of a radiation, and it emits a purple color. So the color of Ti3 plus is purple. That's how we can explain the color formation in case of a transition elements. Next important one is a complex formation. The transition elements which form a complexes with the molecules or ions. Here the molecules or ions which forms a complexes with the central metal atom are called as the ligands. And this complex formation tendency, that is due to the two factors. One is transition metal cations have a smaller size and high charge density, and also they have low lying vacant d orbitals of a suitable energy to accept a lone pair of electrons to form a complex compound. So the ligands which donates a lone pair of electron to the central metal atom, the central metal atom which have a vacant d orbitals to accept that lone pair of electron, and that forms a bond that is called as a complexes or a coordination compounds. And the stability of the complexes, that increases with the increasing atomic number. When the transition elements, when the transition metal atom exhibit a more than one oxidation state, the complex with higher oxidation state has a greater stability. So here we discussed all the properties of a d-block elements. Thank you.